हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर नितिन मोरकानी वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन एन बी नवले सिंहगढ़ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सोलापुर। आई हैव 10 ईयर एक्सपीरियंस, 9 ईयर टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस एंड 1 ईयर इंडस्ट्रियल एक्सपीरियंस। आई हैव कम्प्लीट माई पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन इन मैकेनिकल डिज़ाइन इंजीनियरिंग। टूडे वी स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक इन मशीन डिज़ाइन टू, helical gears. This is the first lecture on helical gears. In this lecture we discuss the following points: introduction, terminology of helical gears, virtual number of teeth, tooth proportion, and the last point we solve one numerical based on a terminology and tooth proportion. Introduction. Now see, these are the two gears, spur gear and helical gear, and last few lectures we deals with the spur gear, and there is a basic difference between spur and helical gears. While the teeth of a spur gears are cut parallel to the axis of shaft, and the teeth of a helical gears are cut in form of helix on a pitch cylinder. Remember, this is very important. In case of a spur gear, the contact between the meshing teeth occurs along the entire face width of the tooth, resulting in sudden application of load, which in turn result in impact condition and generate a noise in high speed applications. Now the next part, in case of a helical gear, the contact between meshing teeth begins with the point on a leading edge of the tooth and gradually extended along the diagonal line across the tooth, and there is a gradual pickup of load by the tooth, resulting in smooth engagement and quiet operation even at high speeds. This is the very important thing about the helical gear. Helical gear is basically used in automobiles, turbines, high speed application, even up to the velocity of 3000 meter per minute. Remember, 3000 meter per minute. There are two basic type of helical gears, parallel and crossed. The discussion in this chapter is mainly limited to the design of parallel helical gears. Next point, terminology of helical gear. See this, this is the see the sketch. This is the conventional representation of a pair of a parallel helical gears. It is necessary to show the hands of helix or the direction of tooth on the drawing. The hands of helix is indicated by drawing three thin continuous line. How to indicate the helix or direction of tooth? By drawing three thin continuous line. Now see the sketch. The lines are sloping downward, that three thin lines sloping downward to the right side for the right-handed helical gears, and that three thin lines sloping upward to the right side for left-handed helical teeth. That is clearly shown in this conventional representation. This is the figure B. This is the top portion of this sketch is the top portion of a parallel helical gears. Middle sketch, that is the top portion of a parallel helical gear, and that top portion is cut into two section, XX and YY axis, and that is section in drawn along that particular axis. Now observe the sketch carefully. See the first point. The line A1, B1 and A2, B2. The line A1, B1, A2, B2 are the center lines of adjacent teeth taken on a pitch plane. Center line of the adjacent tooth taken on a pitch plane. Now see, next parameter, next in this sketch, the next parameter. The angle A1, B2, A2 is the helix angle, and that denoted by letter psi. angle A1, B2, A2. Helix angle denoted by letter psi, and this helix angle is defined as the angle between axis of shaft and the center line of tooth taken on a pitch plane. Angle between axis of shaft and the center line of a tooth taken on a pitch plane. Now observe the sketch. X-axis is the plane of rotation, while the YY is plane perpendicular to the tooth element. Now the distance, see the sketch, the distance A1, A2 is called transverse circular pitch and denoted by letter P suffix N, and this is measured along the plane of rotation. The distance A1C is called normal circular pitch, that denoted by letter P suffix N, and that is measured along the plane perpendicular to the tooth element. Now observe the sketch. From this sketch, consider a triangle A2A1C, and from this triangle we consider a cos psi, that is adjacent side to the hypotenuse. Adjacent side is A1C and the hypotenuse A1A2. Adjacent side, that is the distance A1C, and the hypotenuse is the distance A1A2. Cos psi is equal to A1C divided by A1A2. A1C is the normal circular pitch and A1A2 is the transverse circular pitch. Therefore the cos psi is equal to the small p suffix n divided by small p, and therefore that normal circular pitch, that is small p suffix n, is equal to p into cos psi. That is considered as equation 1. Now we know about the terminology of a spur gear. There are two important points in case of a terminology of a spur gear: circular pitch and diametral pitch. Circular pitch is the ratio of circumference to the number of teeth in case of a spur gear. Circular pitch, circumference to the number of teeth, and the diametral pitch, that is number of teeth to the pitch circle diameter. Circular pitch denoted by letter small p and diametral pitch denoted by letter capital P. And when we take a product of that circular pitch and diametral pitch, we get a value pi. Remember this, the product of circular pitch and diametral pitch is equal to pi. This is asked for 1 mark in MCQ. Okay, it is very important. Now the next thing, small p into capital P. Small p is the circular pitch and capital P is the diametral pitch, and that product, that is equal to the pi. Okay, in above expression we get a capital P suffix n is equal to capital P divided by cos psi. Capital P suffix n, that is normal diametral pitch. Capital P is the transverse diametral pitch. Now one thing about the diametral pitch, it is also called as a reciprocal of module. Now that's why we substitute the value of capital P is equal to M in above expression. See the expression number one. Normal circular pitch is equal to transverse circular pitch into cos psi. Expression number two, normal diametral pitch is equal to transverse diametral pitch divided by cos psi. Now one thing is known to you, diametral pitch also, it is called as a reciprocal of module. That's why we have to substitute the value of capital P is equal to 1 by m in expression number 2. After substituting this value in expression number 2, what do you get? We get normal module is equal to transverse module into cos psi. Mn is equal to m into cos psi. Mn is the normal module, that is in millimeter. M is the transverse module in millimeter. That is called expression number 3. Now observe the sketch figure B. In this figure, the distance A1 B2 is called axial pitch, and that denoted by letter small p suffix a. For obtaining this value, we consider a triangle A1, B2, A2. From this triangle, we consider a tangi, front side to the adjacent side. Front side is A1, A2, and adjacent side is A1, B2. A1, A2 is the transverse circular pitch, that is small p, and A1, B2 is the axial pitch, that is small p suffix a, and therefore that axial pitch is equal, sorry, axial pitch is equal to transverse circular pitch, sorry, transverse circular transverse circular pitch divided by tan alpha. Using this expression, we get a value of a axial pitch. Now this transverse circular pitch, again it is pi into m divided by tan alpha. Okay, using this expression we get the value of axial pitch. Next, again observe the sketch, observe the section XX and section YY. In this section there are two angles, alpha and alpha suffix n. Alpha is the transverse pressure angle and alpha suffix n is the normal pressure angle, and the value of this normal pressure angle, that is alpha suffix n, is always 20 degree. And there is a relation between these three angles, that is helix angle, transverse pressure angle and normal pressure angle. The relation is like that: cos psi is equal to tan alpha suffix n divided by tan alpha. That is called equation number 5. Next thing, pitch circle diameter of helical gear. Then how to obtain the value of pitch circle diameter of helical gear? The pitch circle diameter of helical gear denoted by letter small d. Small d is equal to z, number of teeth, into circular pitch divided by pi. Using this expression, we get the value of a pitch circle diameter of a helical gear. Again, we use another expression, z divided by capital P, and capital P is the diametral pitch. Diametral pitch. Okay, now it is again reciprocal of module, that's why we have to write z into m. And from equation number 3, that m is equal to mn divided by cos, and substituting this value in the in this expression, therefore d is equal to z mn divided by cos psi, equation that we called equation number 6. And using this equation, we obtain the value of pitch circle diameter of helical gear. Okay, now the next parameter in terminology, center distance. Center distance denoted by letter a, and we know the relation for center distance: pitch circle diameter of pinion divided by 2 plus pitch circle diameter of gear divided by 2. Now how to obtain the pitch circle diameter of helical gear? Z suffix p, we obtain the pitch circle diameter of pinion, that's why we use z suffix p mn divided by cos psi plus z suffix g mn divided by cos psi 2 cos psi. Z suffix p mn divided by 2 cos psi plus z suffix g mn divided by 2 cos psi. And from this expression we take a common mn normal module divided by 2 cos psi, and inside the bracket zp plus zg, called as equation number 6. And from using this expression we obtain the center distance. And the last parameter in terminology of helical gear, that is the gear ratio. Gear ratio denoted by letter I. Gear ratio denoted by letter I, and it is obtained in similar manner, in case of similar manner as for the spur gear, that I is equal to the number of teeth on a gear divided by number of teeth on a pinion, or speed of pinion divided by speed of gear. Speed of pinion divided by speed of gear. Or another expression, pitch circle diameter of gear divided by pitch circle diameter of pinion. This is the terminology of a helical gear. Remember the points and terminology of helical gear. First point, relation between normal module and the transverse module, that is Mn is equal to M cos I. Then how to obtain the axial pitch, that is P suffix A. P suffix A is equal to transverse circular pitch divided by cos I. And that transverse circular pitch, that is small p, is equal to pi into m. And the normal circular pitch, that is small p suffix n, is equal to pi into mn. Remember these two relations. Then the relation between three angles, helix angle, normal pressure angle, and the transverse pressure angle, that cos I is equal to tan alpha n divided by tan alpha. After that, the pitch circle diameter of a helical gear, that is zmn divided by cos I. Center distance mn divided by 2 cos I inside the bracket zp plus zg. Zp is the number of teeth on a pinion and zg is the number of teeth on a gear. And the last one is the gear ratio, that I is equal to the number of teeth on a gear divided by number of teeth on a pinion, or speed of pinion to the speed of gear, or the pitch circle diameter of gear to the pitch circle diameter of pinion. This is the whole terminology of a helical gear. Now let's move toward the next point. Virtual number of teeth. this point is very important in examination. One question asked on a virtual number of teeth: derive the virtual number of teeth on helical gear. It is asked for 5 to 6 marks. Now observe the sketch. Everyone observe the sketch. See the pitch cylinder. The pitch cylinder of helical gear is cut by the plane AA, which is normal to the tooth element, normal, that is perpendicular to the tooth element. The intersection of plane AA and the pitch cylinder produce an ellipse, and this ellipse is shown by the dotted line. Now see, observe the sketch, observe the ellipse which is shown by the dotted line. There are two axes of ellipse, semi-major axis and semi-minor axis. Semi-major axis is d divided by 2 cos psi and semi-minor axis is d by 2 respectively. Okay, semi-major axis is d divided by 2 cos psi and semi-minor axis is d by 2. That is clearly shown in the sketch. Now that is the another important thing. It can be proved from analytical geometry that the radius of a curvature r dash, see what I said, the radius of a curvature r dash, that r dash is also clearly shown in the sketch, at point B is given by r dash is equal to a square by b. R dash, that is the radius of curvature at point B, R dash is equal to A square divided by B, where A and B are the semi-major and semi-minor axes respectively. Now substituting the values of A and B in the expression of R dash, and after substituting this value, we get R dash is equal to D divided by 2 cos square alpha, and that called expression number one. See, once again I will repeat this thing. The pitch cylinder of helical gear cut by the plane AA, and that plane is perpendicular to the tooth element. The intersection of that plane AA and pitch cylinder produce an ellipse. When that two planes are intersect, that produce an ellipse, and that ellipse is shown by the dotted line. There are the axis of that ellipse are semi-major and semi-minor axis, that is shown also in sketch. D semi-major axis is D divided by 2 cos psi and semi-minor axis is D by 2. Okay, and one thing is very important from the analytical geometry: the radius of curvature R dash at point B is given by R dash is equal to A square divided by B. And A and B both are a semi-major and semi-minor axis. Now we have to just substitute the value of semi-major and semi-minor axis, and we get a value of radius of curvature R dash at point B. R dash is equal to D divided by 2 cos square alpha, and that expression we call as expression number first. Now, in the design of helical gear, an imaginary spur gear is considered in plane AA. See what I said? In the design of helical gears, an imaginary spur gear is considered in plane AA with center at O dash, having a pitch circle radius R dash and modulus mn. See, we consider imaginary spur gear, okay, along a plane AA as a center O dash, pitch circle radius R dash and modulus mn. It is called as a formative or virtual spur gear. What I called? Formative or virtual spur gear. Now, the diameter D dash of the virtual gear, that is D dash, 2 times R dash. Substitute the value of R dash, 2 into R dash. R dash is, that is in expression number 1, D divided by 2 cos square alpha. And therefore, the pitch circle diameter of this virtual gear D dash is equal to D divided by cos square alpha, called expression number 2. The number of teeth Z dash on the imaginary spur gear. See what I said? We already consider an imaginary spur gear with a center O dash, pitch circle radius R dash, and modulus MN. Okay, and that gear we called as a virtual or the formative spur gear. Now we consider the number of teeth on that formative gear is Z dash. Okay, the number of teeth Z dash on imaginary spur gear is called as a virtual number of teeth. Is called as a virtual number of teeth. Now this virtual number of teeth, how to obtain the virtual number of teeth? Z dash is equal to 2 pi R dash divided by normal circular pitch. Normal circular pitch mn, small p suffix mn. Okay, now just here we substitute the value 2 pi. We know the value of R dash, that is present in expression number first, that is D divided by 2 cos square alpha, and the normal normal circular pitch, that is pi into mn. Now just simplify. Z dash is equal to D divided by normal module into cos square alpha. Now we know the value of we know the expression for pitch circle diameter of a helical gear, that is D is equal to Z mn divided by cos alpha, and this value, this expression is substituted in above expression. Therefore Z dash is equal to Z mn divided by mn cos square alpha into cos alpha. Mn get cancelled. Therefore Z dash, that is virtual number of teeth on a gear, Z dash is equal to Z divided by cos cube alpha. This is the expression for virtual number of teeth, in that Z is the actual number of teeth. Okay, this formula is also very important, that is also asked in multiple choice question for 1 mark. Virtual number of teeth and given a 4 option, and in 4 option this option is given, Z dash is equal to Z divided by cos cube alpha. This is about the virtual number of teeth. Now next thing that is very important thing, tooth proportion. Tooth proportion in helical gear, the normal module. Normal module, we know the symbol for normal module, that is small m suffix small m. That is the letter is usually used to denote the normal module in case of a helical gear. And the value of this normal module should be selected from the standard values. That standard values in available in a design data book. The first preference value of normal module, that is given in a design data book, 1, 1.25, 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, and 10. These are the first preference value for the normal module in case of a helical gear, and this value available in a design data book. Okay, when we refer a design data book, we get this all value for the normal module. Now next, in a tooth proportion, first about the normal module. And this is the first preference value for the normal module. Next is the second point is the standard proportion for addendum and dedendum. The first thing, addendum, in case of a helical gear, addendum denoted by letter small h suffix a, and that is equal to the normal module. Dedendum denoted by letter h suffix small f, and that is equal to 1.25 times normal module. And the clearance small c, 0.25 times normal module. 0.25 times normal module. Next, third point in a tooth proportion, addendum and dedendum circle diameters. Addendum circle diameter denoted by letters d suffix a, and addendum circle is the extreme outermost circle for in case of a gear, and that is equal to pitch circle diameter 2 times addendums. Now we know the relation for pitch circle diameter of helical gear, z mn divided by cos alpha plus 2 into addendum. Addendum, that is 2 times normal module. Now from this expression we take a normal module common, and inside the bracket z divided by cos alpha plus 2. Then the expression for addendum circle diameter d suffix a is equal to normal module inside the bracket z divided by cos alpha plus 2. Similarly, dedendum circle diameter denoted by letter d suffix f, and dedendum circle diameter is a extreme innermost circle in case of a gear, and that is equal to pitch circle diameter of a gear minus 2 times dedendum. Now pitch circle diameter of helical gear zmn divided by cos alpha minus 2 into dedendum, that is 1.25 times normal module. Then the expression zmn divided by cos alpha minus 2.5 times normal module. Again, from these two equation we take a common mn, inside the bracket z divided by cos alpha minus 2.5. then the expression for dedendum circle diameter for the helical gear is outside the bracket normal module, inside the bracket 2 divided by cos alpha minus 2.5. this is the expression for dedendum circle diameter of a helical gear. Okay, and the normal pressure angle alpha suffix n is always 20 degree, and the helix angle varies from 15 degree to 25 degree. 15 degree to 25 degree. This is about the tooth proportion in case of a helical gear. Now let me start one numerical based on a terminology and tooth proportion. First of all, everyone read the problem statement carefully. A pair of parallel helical gears consist of 20 teeth pinion meshing with 40 teeth gear. The helix angle is 25 degree and the normal pressure angle is 20 degree. The normal module is 3 millimeter, and calculate these 6 parameter. First one is the transverse module, transverse pressure angle, axial pitch circle diameter of pinion and gear, the center distance, and the last one, addendum and dedendum circle diameter of pinion. Now, first of all, read the problem carefully. After that, collect the given data. Now, first of all, we collect the given data. Number of teeth on a pinion is 20, z suffix p. Number of teeth on a gear is 40, z suffix g is equal to 40. Helix angle is given 25 degree. 25 degree. And normal pressure angle is given 20 degree. Normal pressure angle is given 20 degree. And last thing is also given. Normal module m suffix n is equal to 3 millimeter. Now let me find these unknown terms one by one. The first term is the transverse module. Transverse module denoted by letter small p. Transverse module denoted by letter small m. Now we know the relation between normal module and transverse module. Normal module m suffix n is equal to transverse module into cos psi. And therefore, transverse module M is equal to normal module divided by cos psi. Normal module is given 3 millimeter, cos psi helix angle is 25 degree. Now simplify this and we get a transverse module, that is small m, is equal to 3.3101 millimeter. Follow 4 digit after point for getting a correct Correct answer, or the closer to correct answer. Now the number two, transverse pressure angle. Transverse pressure angle denoted by letter alpha. Now how to obtain this transverse pressure angle? For obtaining the transverse pressure angle, we know the relation between three angles. That relation is cos alpha is equal to tan alpha suffix n divided by tan alpha. And therefore, tan alpha is equal to tan alpha suffix n divided by cos psi. And therefore, alpha is equal to tan inverse inside the bracket tan 20 divided by cos 25. Simplify this. Take a tan inverse and alpha, that is transverse pressure angle, is 21.8802. 21.8802. Now the third parameter, axial pitch. Axial pitch, that is small p suffix a, and it is find by using the expression transverse circular pitch divided by tan alpha. Transverse circular pitch is pi into transverse module divided by tan alpha. Now substitute the values. Pi into transverse module 3.3101 divided by tan 25 degree. Simplify and we get a axial pitch. Axial pitch 22.3006 millimeter. Next parameter, pitch circle diameter of pinion and gear. Pitch circle diameter, that is small d suffix p. It's first of all we find out the pitch circle diameter of pinion, and that denoted by letter d suffix p, and that is z suffix p mn normal module divided by cos alpha. Number of teeth on a pinion is 20. Normal module is 3 millimeter divided by cos 25 degree. Simplify, we get a pitch circle diameter of a pinion. Pitch circle diameter of a pinion is 66.2026 millimeter. Similarly, pitch circle diameter of gear, that is d suffix g, z suffix g mn divided by cos psi. That z suffix g is a 40 into 3 divided by cos 25. Simplify, we get a pitch circle diameter of gear, and pitch circle diameter of gear is 132.4053 millimeter. Next thing, number fifth, center distance. Center distance given by letter A, and it is given by the expression normal module divided by cos psi inside the bracket zp plus zg. Now substitute the values. Normal module is 3 divided by 2 into cos 25 degree. Number of teeth on pinion 20. Number of teeth on gear 40. Now simplify and we get a center distance, and the value is 99.30395 millimeter. And the last parameter is the addendum and dedendum circle diameter of pinion. Addendum circle diameter denoted by letter d suffix a suffix p for the pinion. Now we know the expression normal module inside the bracket z suffix p divided by cos psi plus 2. Just substitute the values. Normal module is 3, number of teeth on pinion 20, cos 25 degree plus 2. Simplify and we get a pitch circle diameter of a addendum circle diameter of a helical gear, and the addendum circle diameter is 72.2026 millimeter. Similarly, dedendum circle diameter, that is d suffix f suffix p for pinion, mn inside the bracket zp divided by cos psi minus 2.5. Substitute the values. Normal module is 3, number of teeth on a pinion 20, cos 25 degree minus 2.5. Simplify. The pitch, the dedendum circle diameter of pinion, that is 58.7276 millimeter. Now similarly, obtain the addendum and dedendum circle diameter for the gear. Okay, this is about the first lecture on a helical gear. In this lecture, we discussed the introduction, terminology, virtual number of teeth, tooth proportion, one numerical on a terminology and tooth proportion. Thank you very much.